Hi guys, welcome to this video. In this video, we are going to implement Africa's Talking Core Bank URL. It is the extension of our first video that I implemented. And in the first video, I implemented Africa's Talking SDK push payment API. And just a recap of what I did in that video, I created this function for processing payment information to Africa's Token. Then from there, I created a loop for handling that function. This is the loop that I created. And I was using a Postman for doing testing. And this is the endpoint that execute our function and send a request now to Africa's Token. And when I hit these endpoints, we will receive an SDK push in the Africa's Talking simulator. As you can see, this is the SDK push that was set by Africa's Talking, and we are able now to do this in our first video. This is our achievement, and in this video, we are going to create a core bank URL, and I want to take you to, let's first for example this transaction by selecting one, and then said that means client have accepting the transaction. Let's go now to the Africa's Talking documentation and understand the entire logic from the beginning up to the end, as we are dealing with the mobile checkouts where it is a customer to business, and there are four steps which the transaction go through. The first one is where the request is sent now to Africa's Talking, like what we have done, and then from there let's go to our postman. When he set request now to Africa's Talking, they give us a response for just that one request, and this is the response that we receive from Africa's Talking, and the status is success. That means our request have succeeded. Then from there, the Africa's Talking proceed or set the request, the one that have sent to them, to the client side. So they process the request now to the client's side. That's step two. Send a request to the phone, and we have received a request here where we have accepted. After the client have accepted, Africa's Talking receive client's validates, or rather another response from client side. This is if the clients have declined the transaction or client have accepted. But in our case, we have accepted the transaction. Now, the last step is now receiving the response from Africa's Talking into our backend. And that's what we are going to do in this video. And we are going to save our transaction in our database here. So this is the table. I have a database, and then I have a table. We are going to save all the information from Africa's Talking in this table. And that's what we are going now to implement, and we'll put our core bank URL just here, products. Then we go now to the products. We are going to put our core bank URL here so that we can be able now to receive a response from Africa's Talking. So let's go ahead and do the actual coding in our environments. I want to go to the same controller, payments controller, and down here I start creating the function for handling the logic. I will call it a core bank URL. Request a variable. a request, then inside there we'll receive a JSON response from Africa's talking. So first we are going now to save that JSON response into a certain variable that I'm going to create lying now. Let me later comment of what you are doing. You are going to install the received JSON. In a variable, we'll call it a callback. That's where we are going on to save our JSON that's coming from Africa's talking. Yes, let's go ahead and create a variable call bank. You assign it to file get a contact. You are receiving the input from the client, so it will be inputs. Then from there we are going to decode what we have received from the Africa stocking as a response. So we'll see decode the received JSON in a variable code, and then we are going to receiver then store into variable code. Just call it a callback URL, and then we get that variable here, callback URL, and then from there we recall this one, so JSON decode. We are decoding the received JSON, and then the last argument is true. Then from there, we are going to create an array for processing the information. So let's create an array. We call it a variable callback URL. Let's call it callback response, and then it will be an array. It's equals array, and then we terminate this array here, and then inside here we are going to put our parameters that we're receiving from Africa's talking, and these are some of the parameters that we are getting from Africa's talking. So let's go ahead to transactions. These are the transactions that I have committed today, and I want to get the details. We are going to receive all this information from here, and then we save it in our database, so you can use that information for generating invoice or any other kind of reports. So we are going to have those parameters. I already have them I would have those parameters in my controller, boot controller. So just want to copy and paste it here. Yeah, these are the all the parameters that we are expecting to get from Africa Stocking, starting from category all the way to request metadata. And we are passing this variable here, so I want to replace this one with this. Then we are done with that array. So I want us to save this one in our database. And when you are dealing with an array, we must extract that array. So we say extract. Terminates. We are extracting this guy. Then from there, we are going to apply query builder, so db table, then our table we are going to copy the name here. Let me I want to copy the actual name. Yeah. So we are going to save in this table, so just copy then paste all function we are inserting. So insert in brackets, we are inserting this guy, save there, and terminate that add, and we are done with our function. So I just want to copy the function name. Then I go to our root. I have created a root for that function. This is the root. So I'll just copy, paste function name there, and then you would have this one. This is the name for our root. And then from there, I just want to do testing, so let me start my server here. PHP Hudson serve, so that way. Or rather, I do this. I just put it to a local platform. Yeah, we test it from. Okay, we say git and git commit callback URL. Let's git pull a local master. We are going to use our Postman for testing. So this is the request, and this is the endpoint, and inside our body law. You already have the parameters and the values. So So we're going to test if we'll be able now to insert this information to our database here. And then from there, you move now to the, we copy this URL, this endpoint here, tell the finish, so we can do testing. There's an error. Oh, okay, it is not input, it's in PHP. Yeah, here it is PHP. They take it wrong. Yeah. Commit. Push. And actually, do not have to. This one not double. So, PHP, yes, it should be like that one. And again, comment, push. They are great. Now let's see. Good. We are able now to save our information in our database. So if I go, if we go back to our database here, we will see there's one record that have been saved. Yeah, this is the record that have been added. So we want the second record to come from Africa Stocking. So we just copy this URL and we paste it in our core bank URL section. So here, I come here, core bank, and then paste it here and save. Yeah, now we have our color blank here URL. So when we initiate transaction and client confirm, we'll be able now to receive a response information to our database. So let's go ahead and initiate a transaction here. Send. Come back to simulator. Let's exempt this transaction. Send. Yes. Then let's go back to our database, expecting to have a second record here. Great. Yeah, we have received a response from Africa Stocking mobile checkout, received mobile checkout funds from this phone number, destination payment wallets, that's the destination type, all this information we have received from Africa Stocking, SDK push, and then provider fee, provider, channel, all this information have come from Africa Stocking, and you see the status here, it has succeeded. So guys, we have managed now to get a callback URL that is receive a response from Africa Stocking. So we have implemented everything in this instruction here, and guys, thank you very much for watching my video, and kindly remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and I'm coming up in another video for covering the SMS. So thank you very much, and God bless you.